Okay. Whew. So, how's your StarCraft 2 career going?
After a really good week last week, I'm getting smashed this week.
Oh.
I did a tally, and since our session last Sunday, I've lost 9 and won 2.
Ooh, that's not nice.
So, yeah, so I've been absolutely getting smashed. Now, my MMR at the moment is at about 2400, 2441. And when I'm getting matched with people that are around that 2400, I seem to win fairly easily. But I've been getting matched up with with some people who are like 2600 to 2800, and they're just killing me.
Okay. Huh, yeah, we definitely have to look into that, right?
Yeah.
Can't have my students get smashed around, that's not good.
Well, I had a really good week the week before, so it's going to happen. And because after that really good last week, I went up into Silver One. So
Yeah.
it doesn't surprise me that I'm playing against some better players and I'm going to get matched against some better people.
No, that's true. That's definitely true.
So I've.
What's
I
with
mean.
the what's with the build order? The so-called save one. I think Showtime played it. I'm not quite sure who did it, but last time I gave
Yeah.
you asked for a build order which is said to be safe. Did you practice it? How did the Soul tool work for you?
Yeah, look, it's not bad. I think, because with the other build order where it was more economic, and I think it was the Nexus before Cybercore, I was
Yeah.
getting beaten in the early and mid game. Whereas now I'm making it to in the early and mid game, I actually think I'm probably ahead of most of these dudes. And when I watch the
Okay.
replays, my supply is actually not too bad, and often my army's better, but I'm not being aggressive because my army's just too small at that stage. But
Okay.
then my macro's falling behind, and they're getting ahead once we're at kind of 8 minutes onwards or 10 minutes onwards, and then they're just starting to cream me after that.
Okay.
So, probably and as well as that, I think my scouting hasn't been very effective. So I've been trying to be really active scouting, but it's good enough to kind of see when they're taking an expansion
Yeah, that's
or
very important.
when they're moving out. But it
Those
hasn't been
are,
helpful. Sorry.
yeah. No, you're right. It's difficult. But those are the chances where you can attack the most easily with Protoss. When they move out or when they take another expansion, they make themselves most likely vulnerable, and that's where you can strike. Depending on the build order, you can also try not a pylon but a warp prison, so that you force him not go back to the third base. For example, if he takes a third base, and you fly in with a warp prison. And warp in 7 adepts or zealots, depending on what you play. And then most likely when he moves out or his army is out of position, you force him to attack or to go back. One of those two things. And that's where you can know where his army is. For example, if you go in with a warp prison at his main base and warp in a lot of zealots, then you force a decision out of him. And if he does do this decision to go back while taking a third base, for example, then you can move out with your army and crush the third base, and then you can pull back again. You did damage. You don't necessarily have to kill him with every attack. Sometimes it's better to just attack him, see, oh, I did some damage. For example, if you spread his army into half with force fields and you kill half his army, it's totally fine if you just pull back. You did a lot of damage without losing much, so that's fine. Most people just keep going and warp in and so on to kill him, and that works. But if you have problems with that, it's totally fine to just deal damage and pull back and go for the next tech or so.
Okay. Yep. probably what my scouting hasn't been doing a good job of is actually trying to work out what he's doing in terms of what their strategy is. So I'm seeing some of the big picture stuff, but not that finer detail of exactly what they're trying to do.
Mm-hmm.
And so I've just been getting beaten by all races this week. Everyone's been smashing me.
At least that means you have a lot of replays we can go through, and we can learn a lot of it. So that's the good thing.
Yes. The only thing is, I think Bloody Starcraft has done an update, so I'm not sure whether I can show you the whole weeks, but I'll try to get some going if you want.
Okay. I hope so too. Did they patch again? Oh god.
I think they did. Because I was looking for one from a week ago and it said I could only watch online.
Okay. Offline. Yeah. Offline,
but,
yeah.
But that might have been.
Okay.
So do I promote you now? Is that how I do it?
Exactly. That's how we do it.
Is that lobby host or the leader?
Yep. No lobby host. Perfect.
So this is a Zerg game, and I think I was in front of this guy in the early game, but then
you're fighting ghost people. That's where you want to be. Perfect.
Yeah, okay. Well, I lost against him, but anyway.
No, still, that means that you are skilled enough to be able or allowed to play those guys. So that's...
Okay.
You always need to see the positive. Losing means a new chance.
Yeah, exactly.
Always when I'm playing against a GM, I'm not like, oh man, I won't win. I'm like, okay, now I try the best I can, because that's always an opportunity to just shine. And even if I lose, I know, okay, he is maybe 500 or let it be 1000 MMR above me, but if I can put up a good fight, then that's still something.
Yep.
And the same goes for gold and platinum. If you are playing those people, just relax. If you lose, it's nothing lost. If you win, awesome. So, let's see what we got here. You got this PVC going on. That's very mannered. I like that. I also like that you are putting the pylon not in front of the ramp. Very nice.
Yeah.
So that you can wall off properly.
I did a few things right here, because I'm pretty sure I did start to make the second wall as well.
Oh, that's good. That was the next thing I was checking. So is this now the build order you got from me, or is it still yours with the Adept Immortal?
This is probably, I think this might be a double gateway to open.
Okay, that's also very strong. Yeah, I see double gateway. Okay. Yeah, I have to say I don't play that much Protoss, so I'm not very fit with all the build orders out there currently. Oh god, this Skype is so annoying.
So one thing I've noticed in a lot of my games is that I'm not being aggressive enough, I don't think, in taking new bases.
Yeah.
So every replay I watch, even just taking my third, is far too slow.
Mm-hmm.
And I suspect I've been doing too much chrono on either my Robo Bay to get units out.
Yeah.
And I haven't been doing any chrono on just creating probes. So economy is okay to start, but it does seem to fall behind a bit.
Okay. Let's see what's happening. I think you missed his gas. It's not super bad, but actually you wanna know if he is taking his gas.
That's what I mean with my scouting. It's kind of, I keep sending my probe back to see if he's taking more expos and that kind of thing, but it's not totally effective scouting.
I mean, it's still okay. You go in, let's see if you pull back or if you see... Oh, it's so close to the gas. Okay. That's a little bit unfortunate. But it's okay. What you can do, depending on how many circlings you got, at around minute 3 to 3:30, Zerg wants normally to take the third base. Sometimes they take it at minute 2:30, then they are quite greedy, but that's around where they would take one of those two bases. If they are playing normal, they also can take the gold base if they want to be really aggressive with roaches or mass circlings, something like that. Most likely roaches. So it can happen on maps with gold bases that the Zerg is expanding there as well to just be very aggressive early on and attack you with a timing. So if there are gold bases on the map, probably check. I mean, he's taking his base very late, to be honest. But your... Is this a full wall? Oh, okay. There was the cancel.
See, I
okay.
realized that I'd stuffed that wall up,
yeah.
So yeah.
Do you use in the options? There is, let me see. Where is it? Gameplay. Yeah, if you go to the options and on gameplay, do you have a display build grid? Do you have that enabled?
No.
Okay, I would do this. It looks a little bit disturbing at first, but it will definitely help you to see where you can build and where you can't. It will show you some layout around the place where you want to place buildings. And then you have those little grids where you can way better see, can I build there? Will there be an opening or not? I would also, if on the show unit life bars, what do you have enabled there? Is it on normal or it's on the right?
Normal.
I would go and have damaged.
Okay.
So this will show you every unit that is damaged.
Okay. Yep.
So you can have a better look for your army, which unit is taking damage actually. Gives you a little bit of more. It should get you ahead. Some people are playing completely without it. I think it's very important. You can switch it back if it doesn't help you. Same with the grid. You can always change the options you want. But maybe try it out. Maybe it helps you a little bit.
So I've fallen behind a fair bit here. So I'm 11 probes behind.
Yeah, against Zerg that's fine, I would say. No, not maybe that much. Okay, I have also to say your Nexus was kinda late in this game. However, it's still impressive that you are not that far behind. He is droning quite well.
Yes.
He should drone a little bit more, but still, it's okay. Yeah, there's your Observer. But you don't know... something about his tech. So if you can't see his tech buildings like the Rotron and the Hydralis then because you think it's too risky to go in, at least park your Observer around his army. Okay, he only has some queens now, but still his rally point is right here of his hatcheries, and this is where most likely Zerg will or any player will have their army around the center of all their bases so that they can move the quickest to every location if needed. Because you need to need you against Zerg, you need to know if it is Roach Ravager, then you need or if it's Roach Hydra, then you need quite some force fields, and you can go Colossus, which works. You can go Storm. Early on you go so for some Immortal, I would say Stalker are okay, but not the best. It really depends. PVC is quite difficult to understand, I would say, to know what you have to build. Because it really depends on their army. For example, if they go for Zerglings and Banelings, your current army will get crushed so heavily. Because you can't split it with force fields at all. Stalkers will lose against Zerglings very, very fast. And Zealots will die to Banelings. So all he needs to do is a move into you. And you will see your army just evaporate and be gone.
Okay.
That's the thing. So where's your Observer now? Yeah, it's here.
Yeah.
Okay. I mean, he moves out. If you could see now some roaches, but now he moves out again already. So if you don't get the glimpse of his army, it's difficult to see what he's going for, especially because he didn't build any Hydralisks so far. So that's a small attack he's doing, which you can crush. Army-wise, you are ahead. You don't have any upgrades in this game so far. That's bad for you. So you totally forgot about the fortress. You are still on 5 gateways, where you could go up to 7 if you had the bases taken at the proper time.
And that's the problem here, that I remember that I did want to get some forges going, but I just had no money.
So
I just didn't have my enough probes, you know, early enough.
Yeah. So this is definitely hurting you. 21 of 8. That's hurting a lot on your economy. You have 5 probes too much in that geyser. And that's already enough to saturate your base completely and take a new one. And halfway saturate that. So your saturation definitely needs some more. Oh, and at some point you want to saturate your gases. I know with the style you play, you go early on just on 2 because it's enough.
Yep.
But later on you need that gas.
Yeah.
So your saturation definitely needs something to be looked on. What's with your... Okay, in this game I'm not pretty sure. But are you still often supply capped?
No, not a whole lot.
I've okay.
Pretty decent with supply caps.
Okay, no, that's important that you're
so
not.
So I've got
supply.
My observer following his army here, so I did do something with it, but then
that's,
he brings
that's
it up
good.
In
game. So yeah, at some point, but you, at least you know now it's there. So It's
so
not
I think
too
I was
bad.
Ready for this attack.
Yes. I think you should. I mean, your upgrades are not really good, but you should crush this army.
Yeah,
decisively.
I think I do okay here. It's just his economy is so good. He just keeps spamming me with armies like this, and I just end
He up has a lot of drones. That's true. He can do a lot with his economy. Also, he has the bank. That's the thing. Yeah. So you are reacting now, and if you would have force fields right now, you could split his army right here in 2 pieces, crush half of his army for basically free. It just costs you energy and you will lose some Stalker maybe or some Zealots, and that's it. And then you can move across the map and do the same thing again and win.
And so do you do sentries as a standard against Zerg?
Yes, I would say so. It doesn't hurt you if you have 6 sentries. If you get them time by time, it's definitely worth something. You need to control Zerg's army. If you can't control Zerg's economy, which you don't because you don't harass and you don't attack much, he will just overwhelm you, so at least try to control his army. I mean, you get a lot of damage done, but you could deal way more damage as well. Also, your upgrades are really, I think, what will cost you a lot in this game. What I like is that you are remaking the observer you lost. Okay, that's not looking too bad. Actually, you are trading really well here.
Well, I think he switches to really heavy corruptors really quick, though. And
yes.
I try to go with a whole lot more stalkers. And mine don't have blink yet, I don't think.
You have blink researched already quite some time ago.
So at this point in the game, I actually thought I was ahead here. Because I just didn't realize how many other bases he still had and how good his economy was.
Yes, that's the thing with the scouting. You saw Corruptor, and he's right now making the Greater Spire, which leads into Broodlords, and for that you need to switch into air. Blink Stalker won't cut it for you anymore. It can work, but it's difficult because not only do you need to crush his ground army first to get to the Broodlords, but then you need to blink under them and focus fire all of them while keeping your Stalkers alive from Zerglings and Broodlings with your Colossus, which he needs to get microed against the Corruptor. That's very micro intense And currently, I think it's. You can try it, of course. But switching into air, having Tempest and Carrier out will be better for you, I think. At some point, if it goes to the late game, normally Protoss and Zerg, if they get to this high tech, they always will have air battles. Sometimes you have some High Templar in there, maybe some Archons to or Colossus to clear the ground fast and have storms and so on to back for backup and making retreats possible. But at some point you just get lots of air army, not exclusively, but a lot, like the Golden Armada of Protoss. So we are killing a lot of eggs here, which is fine. As long as he has only Corruptor, you could try to attack with what you got. The problem is you are four upgrades behind. And you need to micro your Colossus in a situation like that. That's the problem. You need to pull them back a little bit so that his Corruptor fly over your Stalker. But in this case, you can't really win this because he deals so much damage and you don't. Your Stalker are barely tickling the queens with the upgrade advantage he got. And of course, while you do all this attack, you don't warp in anything at home. Your robotics is offline, not producing stuff. Your gateways are super idle. And now you're floating. That's the thing where I said, if you're floating minerals, spend them. Because right now, if your attack is over, which will soon be the case if he crushes this attack, you want to rebuild your army as quick as possible. With only six gateways, it will take you 2 to 3 minutes to be maxed out again, even if you spend chrono boosts, which you can. You can chrono boost your gateways if you feel like you have to. It will make that you can warp in the next round earlier. So that's something you can do. You can use chrono boost on your warp gates as well as your
Okay, I didn't
robotics
know that.
facility. Awesome. Always glad I can teach you something new. Yeah,
Yeah,
it will. It you get this 50% boost earlier, so you can chrono boost warp gate. Not only research, you can chrono boost your facilities, robotics facilities, Stargate. You can chrono boost everything which researches or produces something.
Yep, okay.
So also the gateways are part of it. But still, even if you would do that, it will take you a long time. And if you would have thrown down five gateways more, you could have this time you need. You could also throw down a second robotics facility because Zerg has four hatcheries now, which is a lot of larva, especially if he uses the inject, which doubles his amount. And he will ju I guess he will just overwhelm you because you can't spend your money.
He's
So
even
let's
got a macro
see.
hatch, I think.
I like that you're getting Storm, but for that you need a High Templar with energy, and for that you need to warp in them as early as possible. Because right now they are just useless. And that's the
And I
sad
think, yeah,
part.
by the time I made some, they just got picked off straight away.
Yeah. So now you could blink under the Brood Lords and try to focus fire them.
Yeah, I don't think you can blink from where
Ah,
they
there
are.
you go, okay.
So that
But
guy's
that's the
positioned up
thing.
really smart.
Yeah, that's the thing what I just said, that you can try it, but you will have problems against the broodlings. So that's why you go into air. And then you have lots of Tempests, you have Storms against the Ball of Corruptor, maybe some Archons as well for the splash. And what you then want to try is zone his Vipers if you got one, zone his Corruptor, so that they don't get to your Tempest. And with the Tempest you just chip away unit after unit. It's very micro intensive, but you need to to focus fire, pull back, focus fire, pull back. If he comes in, throw storm. That's where it gets really difficult, but that's exactly the way how it goes. At some point, you will need to learn that, I guess. Especially if he is on terrain like that, where you can't really blink under his broodlords. And even if you do so, there would be lots of roaches to pick them off, so you need to transition. And for that you need the gases, which you didn't take. I mean, you take them, but you didn't saturate them. Sadly. So.
Yep. so I got smashed.
That's the thing. And that the sad part is, you got smashed with a bank. You got like 5k minerals. If you would have saturated the gases, maybe 2.5 or 3k. And if you would have spent that money, you easily could have won. Potentially, with the with good upgrades, which you lacked in this game as well, but the potential was still there.
Yeah. So did I have any upgrades at all? No, that's terrible.
Yeah. I see you got the gateways at some point, but they are still in the gateway form, not the gate warp gate. What I like better is that you don't have, unless that one pylon in your natural, the rest of your buildings is saturated with pylons all over. So there won't be one pylon powering five gateways or a lot of tech. That one here is a little bit critical, but it's looking better than before, I would say.
Sorry, all your pings are showing up at the same spot. Do you mind just waiting a second, showing me that critical one again, please?
Yes, let's see. No, no, it's totally fine. That one is critical.
Yeah.
And that one a little bit, because of the robotics facility and maybe the Twilight Council. Yeah. If you have researched everything, it should be fine. But definitely the robotics would be unpowered. And that's the most important part, actually. Yeah. But other than that, your pylon saturation looks quite good, I would say. At least everything is...
And I've got a few hard lessons from some mutas recently as well.
So. Oh, okay. Yeah, this can be really rough, that's true.
All right, you want to move on to the next one?
Yes, please.
This is another one I've got absolutely smashed.
So let's see. Maybe we find a pattern.
This one again. I think I was doing okay right at the beginning, but then this Terran came and set up shop just outside my base. So I was busy scouting him, but I wasn't scouting just outside my own base.
Okay.
He just set up camp there, and I was stuck on two bases, and he just completely overwhelmed me.
Okay.
I find this dream capture map particularly difficult.
You can veto maps if you want to. Yes. You have three
I didn't
vetoes.
I that until halfway through the week and I started vetoing
okay.
this map.
Okay. No, it makes sense. If you have difficulties on a map, just veto it, because you don't need to play hard on yourself. I also use vetoes all the time, because I'm not playing on tournaments, so I don't need to be perfect on every map. So that's totally fine. So, gateway, scouting, I like that.
Yeah, so that's pretty much my go-to now. I drop that gateway and scout. And I did at least check the back here to see what he was up to.
Yes, you also saw both gases, exactly, so that's good.
I think I leave this probe there just to keep coming and checking on his timing for that second base.
Yes. If he goes double gas, it's unlikely to have the base thrown down early.
I think he might have taken either one or both of the gold bases as well.
Okay.
Might be a different game.
Uh-huh.
And I don't scout them as early as I should. That's
okay. At least you're scouting here, but with two gases, it's very unlikely that he takes the space. It's still good that you scouted, but if you see two gases taken that early from a Terran, it most likely means some kind of aggression. Where you are totally fine against with your build. You should crush whatever he's doing. What you can do is, if you play double gateway, you don't have to skip the first zealot. You can get the first zealot out, and then you will still be able to relatively on equal time get the bow stalker or both adepts, depending on what you want. Stalker are, I think, what you normally do. You should get the zealot if you play this, because it adds more oomph to your army, more strength. And it's never bad. It's a good tank, especially against Reaper. It's also quite good against Marines. It's awesome against SUVs. And normally, if you play this double gateway, you want to be aggressive. You move across the map and try. Okay, here it's maybe not that great to do it because he goes for the double refinery, which means aggression. But if you only spot one refinery and you go the double gateway attack or build attack, you most likely will be able to cancel his command center when it's almost done, which will set him back so far that then you are ahead from just that. And it's relatively safe, because if he only opens up with a barracks and gets the factory late, you will be able to contain him with that kind of build order. So get the Salad and then double Stalker. With the Salad, if you scout, should you move across the map? You can try. I would have the Salad. Yes, go across with the Salad, but he will go Reaper most likely, and you don't want to lose the Salad to the Reaper. So what you do, especially on Dreamcatcher, you park your Salad in this spot, right into the side blockers, where he can't attack it without going in, and if he goes in, your Salad can attack the Reaper. And then you just wait for the Stalker to join the Salad, and then you move further. You still have the probe to scout what's going on, probably, if it wasn't taken out by the Reaper. And then you have all the intel you know. You can cancel the command center, you can pressure him, take your Nexus behind, get the double forge, get your robotics, get your tech. He's still scared. And you when he lands his command center, you are saturated already, can take your third base, you are so far ahead that you should win.
When I'm playing against Terran, this ramp blocking, should I be doing that, or is that really just against Zerg and maybe me?
Against Terran, I wouldn't recommend it, really.
Where I've had my army down near my natural, and I've got dropped at my main base, and I've actually found having the ramp blocked has hurt me.
Yes, that's the thing. The ramp block can be nice if he is playing Hellion Drop. Currently, in the GSL, a lot of Terrans are proxying against Protoss. They proxy their barracks, put it near your base, like here for example.
Yep.
So the Reaper will be super early out and harass your probes. They will follow up with a proxy factory for Hellions, proxy starport for a dropship, and then they will drop you, potentially with the Hellions. And if they then want to move from the main base to the natural, and you have this wall, at least they can't get down to your natural with the Hellions. For example, if you would have where your probe is right now blocking, if there is an Adept or a Stalker, Stalker would be the most ideal, I think, on hold position.
Yep.
The Hellions can't pass through, but if you select all your probes and right click on the mineral field in your natural, they will slip through. They can pass each other. There won't be any collision anymore. So you can rescue your probes through the Stalker, which is still blocking your entrance. Of course, against Hellions, you need to be very careful, because if the probes line up that perfectly, he will just murder them. So it has its advantages and its disadvantages. You don't need to wall against Terran, at least. So that's... You can do it. Sometimes it's helpful, sometimes it's not. Most Protoss I play don't, so maybe just don't as well.
Okay.
What they do is they wall off, but they wall off at their Nexus and the Gas Geyser. So if a Reaper jumps in and wants to go behind the mineral line, they will get stuck, so that they can't roam free in your main base. I can show you that with some pings.
Yeah.
They will have the pylons and the gateways above the Nexus and the left assimilator in a meta that the Reaper and no other unit can't go through there anymore. So if the Reaper jumps in at your ramp, goes down on the right assimilator, wants to scout everything, he will get stuck, and he needs to go through the mineral line or back again, which most likely gives you the opportunity with a stalker or adept to kill it. That's what Protoss in my league do most likely against me. Okay, so here's your Scouter Reno, there is his Reaper Reno moving across the map. And as you can see, okay, he's getting a second barrack, so that would make it a little bit difficult. But you would normally have soon one Zealot and two Stalker, and he has only one Reaper. And one Reaper has no chance against anything what you got. So if you would move across the map then, you can deal a lot of damage.
I think I do.
Okay, let's see.
I feel like I'm ahead in this game. Like, not a lot of damage, but I do a little bit.
Okay, you see what the Reaper does now? Exactly what I just told you. Moves behind the mineral line, and if you would have buildings across your Nexus and the Assimilator, you would block it, and the two Stalker could definitely kill it. I don't know if they will now. Probably they will. Oh, so close! Oh, you still get it. Okay.
He stuffs up where he puts it. So I think now I might march across. No, I don't. Okay, I think I got worried that he had more Reapers than was going to send him over.
Yeah, and you are not moving across the map. That's the thing. So you definitely could. Long time ago. As soon as the two Stalker are out with the one Zealot, you could move across the map. Because he doesn't have anything. Now he has a Marauder, but until then you could have maybe killed an add-on or maybe the supply depot. Just contain him, deal a little bit of damage. You don't need to overcommit or waste your army. You also get scouting if you do that. You get a lot of intel on what he's doing, what kind of units he gets. So that definitely can help you. Okay, so currently this pylon is a little bit critical because it powers so much. And you definitely need to resaturate your base. And have some probes down the natural. Yeah. And of course, saturate your gases. At some point, let's see when the base finishes. When is your base finished? Yes. Okay. In this case, at 4:13, your base is done, and that's where you then should start to saturate it. Because you will lose a lot of minerals and you will mine out your main base way too fast if you don't do it. So you stick with your saturation for a long time. Like 1 minute, maybe even two. Yeah, that's a lot. And you're banking up a lot of minerals again. Partly because of your... Why did you say sorry? Were you AFK?
I've got a wireless mouse and keyboard, and every now and then it just gets a bit laggy or something. So I'm actually going to go buy a new, like a gaming mouse and keyboard this week. So it froze up on me.
Oh.
I ended up having to pause.
Okay, that's unfortunate. That should not happen.
No.
Okay, but that explains why you potentially get crushed. I mean, if you can't spend your money properly because of the keyboard is making stupid decisions and stuff. That's...
So you can see he's camped out here. I've just got no idea if his army's even there.
Yes. Yeah, the only thing what you can do is you still have this probe, so get a pylon, maybe there. So that you can warp in Zealots with charge, move into his natural, force him back, or force him to attack. One of those two things.
Yep.
And if he contains you like that, it's really difficult, I know. But you basically need some, you need a warp prism and warp in enough Zealots for a flank so that he can't, because if you move down the ramp, he will crush you. But if you come from the side, and have the tank fire first shoot on the zealots, which will charge on the siege tanks, and do you then move out the ramp, it should be way better to crush the contain. If you get contained, don't build a big army and try to move down the ramp, it will never work. You need to get your army out of there somehow, and the only way to do it is with a warp prism or a pylon to have to warp in from the side, or you try to make him, he needs to turn back home. Because right now, just imagine this probe would build a pylon 1 minute ago. You have soon 8 gateways, no charge unfortunately, but if you would have charge, you could murder his natural. You could murder his supply depots at the front. He doesn't have much production at all. You could easily, because click on this barracks down there, click at it. There are 5 marauder queued in. Those are 400 to 300 minerals, which he is doing nothing with it. At some point they will be produced, but right now he could produce 3 more barracks with it. Instead, he does nothing. And those are such as mistakes you can abuse. So, because I see this contain happen the second time now to you, definitely with this probe, especially if it's alive, build a pylon somewhere, not at this location where the probe is currently, but maybe more to the north, somewhere where he wouldn't scout it, where he wouldn't get. So, there are plenty of choices where you could get a pylon. But not in potential bases, but around the base. Yeah, maybe totally there.
I didn't think of that at all at the time. You can see me doing exactly what you said. I just should just try to build up my army and just go over the top. I mean, I should have, like you said, built a pylon. And I do even try to send out a probe in a sneaky way to try to take an expand. I should have used that probe.
Yeah. That's the thing. You have this probe. Oh yeah, I see.
So this is, so I've got my observer out there now, and I've realized that.
Yeah, that's the thing. And then you are super scared, and you get nervous, and you're, oh my god, how I'm going to win this? How I'm going to break out? The tension is stacking up.
I think I kept making losses too, and I should have switched back to immortals with all those tanks there. I think.
Yeah, tanks will murder Colossi, that's true. Immortal are better against tanks. That's...
I didn't realize that I needed zealots with charge, but it was just a bit late, and I don't have the best economy to do it either.
So what is really helpful here are definitely charge slots. If you have Archons and Storm with it, would be even better. Immortal and charge slot can work as well, very well. But he's really containing you pretty hard, and there is just no way for you to ever move down this ramp with that amount of siege tanks. Just imagine he would have 5 more liberator or so, for example, adding to his army. There is just no way. So did you see the move out? That's the big question here. If he moves out, where is your observer? Okay, you're checking with the probe for the bases. I like that, for the gold bases, because that could have been the case. That's a very good move.
I've got so much minerals, though, I should have taken it myself. I don't know what I was thinking. Minerals. And
if
I
you,
take it.
But you just have the right ideas, but not to the right time. If
it's just, easy to play well when you're watching the replay when you're not in the
just,
heat of battle.
Just imagine with all your minerals taking, for example, this or that gold base, you can recall most of your probes which are oversaturating your main base to get lots of minerals, throw down 12 gateways, doesn't matter, get all those charge slots, like 30 charge slots, 40, doesn't matter, and then you would have that massive flank. You even could have split those Archons into 2 sets, like 10 zealots. 10 zealots go to his base, attack. The rest crushes the contain. You win on both sides, you win the game. Especially because you can recall your probes. Man, that would be such a smart move.
Well, I didn't do it.
Yeah, that's the sad thing. But you have the right ideas, and that's the good thing. You just need to implement them into your game. In this game, sadly, you don't have the observer anywhere, so I don't think you have any currently. You're getting one right now, but it sticks with your army for a long time, and that's why you don't see the contain happening, because now it's too late. I mean, now it's not. Yeah, you can't crush this with what you got. That's the thing. Okay, the keyboard was definitely bad for you, but still, even with that big,
I still could have lost this game.
you could have won this. That's unfortunate. But I think there's not much happening here now as well. So this is just you getting crushed, I
Yeah,
guess. Yeah.
exactly.
Army-wise, it's looking okay from the supply. Your upgrades are a little bit low, but his are not great either, so okay. Your charge is a little bit late. Just happens to be now. But you can't move out there. It's just that he even has a sensor tower, scans you now. He sees everything you got and he knows you can't move out there. That's the sad part. There's just no way to move down this ramp. Yeah.
Absolutely destroyed.
That's that. Okay, I see. But yeah, with the probe, if you don't lose it, at some point you need to get this pylon to warp in sometimes, some zealots, be a little bit aggressive. You don't need to care about them. You can just warp 8 zealots with charge, A move into something, let them die. It's not perfect, especially if he has his army there, then, but you should see it with the observer. That's the thing. You see his observer, you see his army, don't warp in. You don't see his army, warp in. Attack, success. That's basically the plan. Okay, so let's see what's happened here. Okay, he plays the double gateway. Double gas, double gateway. Nice scouting going on. Unfortunately, he's not taking a base. There's his core. Okay. Okay, double stalker. He's not getting anything. Stargate. It's interesting that he gets double gateway but isn't producing anything out of it.
Yeah,
That's
you're right.
very strange. So he goes into Stargate here. He's now chronoing one Stalker. Two? No, it's you. With a Zealot, potentially you could have crushed him here. Because you would have been up one unit. And in PvP, in any mirror matchup, being ahead in units or upgrades or anything is awesome. It's so much. Normally, if he plays double gate and you play double gate, I wouldn't move out and move across the map because if he macros well, he always will have more units than you if he plays the same opening. What you can do is you can have them somewhat around here potentially. Or maybe down his ramp to have a look, but I wouldn't move up and force a fight. In this case, you could have won, which is sad for him, because that should never happen. But normally he will be up maybe two stalker, and then you just lose a stalker, and then you are down three stalker. Ugh. That's very difficult. For scouting measures, you will get at some point. the observer. What you can do is you can have a pro patrolling down his ramp, or have a stalker there if you take care, because there should be nothing he can do unless he gets a phoenix to kill the stalker. So as long as you don't have your observer out, which will still take a little bit, you can have something down the ramp. Maybe one probe on patrol command, or maybe a stalker on patrol command, so that you just see, is he moving out or not? And if so, then you can just pull back without losing anything.
So this is another case of, so he does some work.
Yes, he goes in with the Oracle. Yeah. But you pull immediately, that's okay, so you lose...
Four,
okay.
Could have been worse, but that having my ramp blocked for PvP didn't help me there
either. Yeah. Fun part, that's the thing. If you have the probe or stalker down there, you can split, or you can have your stalker all in the main base, because you see when he will move in. And the natural is not as difficult to defend as you think. If you would have a proxy pylon, you still could, depending on but at least you could split your army, potentially have some stock in your main, some stock in the natural. You will see if he moves out. The fun part is he killed five probes,
and I'm still ahead of him.
Yeah, you are now even, and so that's, he dealt damage, but it's just damage which makes you even. That's what I always say with the macro. If you macro better, then you don't need to harass, because it will just harm you. If you would have, now he's a little bit ahead, so he needed to deal this damage, so it was okay, but he's not really ahead of you now. So that's a good thing. In this game your saturation looks fine, that's good. You could spend your chrono boost a little bit better. See, that's what I meant. With moving across the map, if you play the same opening, basically. He's now there with 5 Stalker, and you have 6 and 3 Zealots. And you have still 3 Stalker in your main base defending. You just crush him. There's no way for him to win this. You even kill the Oracle, and what you can do now, just move across the map. Potentially you won't win, but you can contain him, probably. If you have one observer, where is your observer? Do we have one observer? No. Doch. Yes, you have one. Moving across the map. You also have this pylon for reinforcements. That's awesome.
I was going to do something sneaky there. So yeah.
So you have 3 gates. He will have 5, but he has no army. He has a shield battery, which is okay. Still, with the observer, you could snipe 2 of his gateways for free. Is damage. Anything you can get. Because you dealt so much damage, you killed 3 Stalker and an Oracle for free, I would move across the map. Yes, because you have the pylon for warp in, which you should use. The observer should be on his army. There you don't see, at least see the ramp. Because now he could take a third base and you wouldn't notice. So a little bit further, maybe have the observer there.
And so with that pylon I've got sitting there, would you suggest normally building a gateway there?
If you want to be aggressive, faster? Yes, it makes sense. So some don't do it, it depends. If you want to be aggressive and really attack, definitely. If you just want to harass, you don't need it. So.
Okay.
If this pylon is just for some DTs or zealots for some point or adapts, you don't necessarily need it. If you want to be aggressive and attack him, then you definitely need it if you don't have a warp person. So, yeah. He's taking a gold base. Okay, sneaky.
Yeah, and I didn't scout this.
You scouted right away.
Yeah, good work. And I think I might get aggressive and go try to take it out now.
I hope so. You shouldn't wait too long. That's the thing, you wait so long before you act.
Yep.
Sent
some DTs in. Okay, but he had cannons there.
Yeah, that's the. And the shield battery. So if you see he has cannons there and that your Dark Templar isn't doing anything, try another base, because the other bases don't have anything to detect him. He doesn't even have an observer, so this DT could kill his entire probe line in two bases. That would be very strong. So you are attacking now, you are down one upgrade, he has Immortal, I think he wins this. Yes. Yeah, that's unfortunate. I guess if you would have attacked earlier... Let's see. So you scouted right now. If you would move out right now and you see with your... That's the thing. Look at your observer. Click on it and press the V button. V. I think it's called V. Yeah. For vision. And you will see, you don't see his army moving out. It's so close to be visible. You barely see it. Still, if you would see it, you then could decide attack his natural or still go for his nexus, because you see he only has some stalker and a sentry and you have way more. If you would go right now, you would cross his army, crush this nexus, you can take your own. I think in this case you just waited way too long and you didn't have the scouting you needed, with the observer being in a bad place. Basically, you are playing pretty well. You just—it's just those small little things which will cost you the game in the end. In this game, you waited too long to kill his nexus. Your upgrades are a little bit late. Do you have a forge? No. So that's the other part of it. But you could have won this. Now it's too late. But before that. Definitely doable.
Yeah. Mm. I was ahead of him too, so.
Yeah, but at least I see you have the right ideas. You just need to execute them a little bit, sometimes at all, and sometimes just a little bit earlier. But it's not as grim as it looked like. So if you tell me, "Ooh, 9 losses and only 2 wins," that looks dark. It sounds bad, but actually. The games didn't look too bad for you at all. It's just those small things, a little bit too much waiting on your side, sometimes a little bit bad decision making. But if you can fix that, you should be gold in no time, actually. Because you are macro-wise, most times what I've seen today, ahead of your opponent. If you can just take the bases properly, saturation, the upgrades and such, it should be totally fine. Here you definitely could have won after you crushed his first attack.
Yeah. So this week I'm gonna aim at trying to get better at chrono boosting my economy out. And
yeah.
I'm gonna try to scout better as well, more effectively.
Yes, you need this observer at his base and ramp and army is so important. So that you know, can I move in? Do I have to move out? You spotted the gold base, and if you would have spotted him moving out with his army, which is not great, you were ahead like 4 Stalker and 3 Zealots. Even with the next round of warbits, you even had a Colossus. You could have crushed his army completely, take out the Nexus, and then from there on just win. So definitely doable.
All good. All right. Well, I'm going to do some practice this week and try to have some more wins.
Awesome. You definitely should be able to get those. I know it's possible.
Terrific. All right. Well, mate, thank you very much. And same time next week, okay with you?
Should be, yes.
Awesome. All right. Well, thanks very much, Alex. I better go. My missus is making me dinner right now. So.
All right. Have a good one. Right.
You too. Thanks, man. See you later.
Yeah, bye. Hey, there. Thank you for watching. If you'd like to support me, simply hit the thumbs up button. Do you have any wishes, feedback or suggestions, put them into the comments below. You may also subscribe if you're new to the channel. I wish you a wonderful and stress-free day. Take care. Bye bye.
Thank you.